Okay, I'm reading Horse Crazy again, and we're reading the book called The Circus Pony. So Bon and Sam have just gone down to have a look around, a snoop around the circus, and they've gone to see the horses. "What are you kids doing?" A skinny man in a black cowboy hat appeared in front of them. "You can't just wander around here." Sam stood her ground. "Anyone can be here. It's the footy oval." The man smiled and smoothed his thin moustache. "Pardon me, senoritas." He pulled a folded paper from the back pocket of his dirty jeans and waved it in the air. "This permit from the council says we can use this ground exclusively for the next week. Circo Circus, which means me, Mr. Circo, can tell anybody to get out." He pushed the paper under Sam's nose and bowed. "And I'm telling you to get out. Vamoose. On your way, ladies. Come back on Friday night for the show." Bonnie and Sam headed for the main gate, walking backwards sometimes to see as much as they could. Mr. Circo watched them all the way. "He's making sure we don't duck around behind a truck," said Sam, waving to him. "But I know how to get up the back of the grandstand. We can hide up high and watch from there." So there's Mr. Circo and there's the permit. The girls sat on the very top step of the grandstand. It was perfect. They could see the whole arena with all the horses. Trucks and caravans were parked around to screen it from the road. "Wow, that horse is as big as a house," Bon pointed. "He'd make Whale look like a pony. It must be Samson." They watched a slim figure lead a black pony into the arena and start to lunge him in a circle. "That must be Belladonna," Sam squinted to see the girl's face. "She doesn't look much older than us." Now the pony was circling smoothly. The girl unclipped the lunging rein, ran beside him and vaulted onto his back. "Look, she's got a special saddle thing, Bonnie. That would make it so much easier. There's a handle on the pommel and loops for your feet." Bonnie couldn't take her eyes off the rider. I'd love to talk to her, but they don't seem very friendly. There's a lovely picture of the big top and all the activity going on as they set up Circo Circus. This chapter is called Circus Girl. On Tuesday night after school, Bonnie and Sam took Tricky down to the creek again. "The talent night's over, losers," sneered Michael. "Why are you still practicing?" The girls just ignored him. Bonnie had taught Pants how to run in front of Tricky holding his lead rein. They wanted to see if Tricky would run in circles after Pants without the rein. Sam put an old pony pad on Tricky with a breastplate, and it made things easier for Bonnie. She was trying to do the suicide drag, lighting right back on Tricky's rump when he snorted and pulled up suddenly. "What the?" Bonnie sat up and her heart jumped. On the other side of the creek was the girl from the circus on her black pony. Her reins were loose and the pony seemed to be waiting for a signal. "Come over," Bonnie shouted. "It's not deep." The black pony picked his way across Currawong Creek as delicately as a ballet dancer, and the girl sat on his back like a princess. Bonnie slid off Tricky and stepped forward. "Hi, you must be Belladonna." "I'm Bonnie," she said. Sam poked a finger to her chest. "And I'm Sam." There you can see her riding across the creek. The beautiful dark-haired girl smiled. "Actually, I'm just Bella, Bella Salvador. The Donna part is just for show." She slid off her gleaming pony and patted his neck. "And this is Jet. What about you two? You look like you're trick riders too." "Not proper trick riders," Bon said. "We're just learning." She jumped aside as Tricky barged up to Jet, ears pricked, and the two ponies sniffed each other. The tension broke with a squeal and a toss of heads. Sam pulled Tricky away. "Sorry, he has terrible manners. He thinks he's the star." "He could be," Bella said. "He's beautiful." Bonnie and Sam told her about the talent night and their squashed dreams. "Yesterday we saw your special saddle, so we were experimenting with Sam's old pony pad," Bonnie explained. "Until now, I've been doing it all bareback." Bella ran her hand along Tricky's back. "I couldn't do what you've been doing bareback, but I can show you some of my tricks." The next 2 hours went faster than any time Bonnie had ever known as Bella shared her skills. When it was time to go, Sam invited Bella to her house after school the next day. "We'll meet here at 4 o'clock, okay?" And there she is on her beautiful black horse. This chapter's called More About the Circus. Next day, everybody was talking about the circus. "They don't even have lions and elephants," scoffed Michael Milton. Bonnie and Sam didn't tell a soul about meeting Belladonna, but they defended the circus fiercely. "It's cruel to make wild animals perform," Bonnie told the class. So they used domestic animals like cows and dogs and horses. Bella arrived after school and the three girls talked for hours about their different lives. It turned out that Bella's family lived on a farm in Queensland when the circus wasn't touring. Nana and Pop look after things when we're away. Bella had twin six-year-old brothers who dressed up as baby pandas in the circus. Everybody has something to do, she explained. Even when I was a baby, Dad made me part of the show. That's how it is in the circus. My dad told me that when he was little, the circus kids used to go to Currawong Creek School when they were in town, said Sam. Yep, that's right, Bella nodded. My dad hated it. She rubbed Pan's tummy with her foot. Our mums and dads had a rotten time always changing schools. So now we have our own travelling school with a teacher and a special caravan, and we do correspondence work on the internet. A nice poster of the circus. This chapter's called The Accident. When Bella came to the creek on Thursday, she had put the trick riding saddle on Jet so she could show the girls her fancy tricks. Jet's glossy coat shimmered as he circled neatly, neck arched. When Bella finished her full routine, Bonnie and Sam clapped and hooted like lunatics. Okay, Bella swung off her pony. Now it's your turn. It was though Tricky wanted to impress Jet. He didn't put a foot wrong, and Bonnie danced on his back like a fairy. Bella couldn't get over how well Bonnie balanced bareback. Then Bella sat on Tricky and he trotted forward. Whoa, he feels so different from Jet, and jumped to her feet in one fluid movement. But at that very moment, Tricky stumbled on a patch of heavy sand and sent Bella flying through the air. She looked so graceful that Bonnie and Sam started to clap, but the scream she let out as she hit the ground silenced them. Oh, my ankle, she cried, holding her foot. I think it's broken. She huddled over, making squeaky, crying noises. So there's a picture of them. And then there she is, flying off. I've got time for one more chapter. Oh no, I finished this one. Let me see. Sam patted Bella's shoulder. I must have landed on something really hard. Sorry, I never cry really, but this hurts. Bella's ankle was as fat as a piglet. It needs ice, Sam said. I'll race up to the house and get some. Mum and Dad will be furious, Bella sniffed as Bonnie held a packet of frozen peas against her ankle. My act is always the finale. Mr. C will probably give Dad the sack if I can't do it. Is your dad Miguel? Sam asked, still puffing from her run. Yep, Miguel's performing horses, Bella replied. But he hurt his back last year and hasn't been able to ride since. Mr. Serco has been threatening to get a new horse master for months. If it wasn't for me and the twins, he would have. I thought he looked like a rat, said Sam. Let me bandage your ankle. I don't think it's broken, just badly sprained. Sam knew a lot about first aid from her dad. What am I going to do, wailed Bella. I can't even stand up. There's no way it's going to be better by tomorrow night. Maybe Bonnie can fill in for you, Sam suggested. That's it. For the first time since her fall, Bella smiled. You could easily do it, Bonnie. Look at us. We're nearly the same size and shape. With my costume and makeup, nobody will be able to tell the difference. Bonnie felt a shiver of excitement, a real circus rider. Come on, Bella begged. Just say you'll at least try. Hop on Jet now and see how you go. But when Bonnie hopped on Jet, he wouldn't go at all. He laid his ears back flat against his head so he looked like a black snake and refused to move. Oh, there they are looking at the poor ankle. All the girls cajoling and bossing made no difference. Even when Bonnie leaned forward and whispered her special horse talk in his ear, Jet wouldn't budge. He only went for one rider and that was Bella. You're a pig, Jet, Bella shouted at him, crying tears of frustration. I hate you. I saw a horse do this at the Melbourne Cup one year, Sam said, trying to calm Bella. I was watching it on TV and this horse just stopped on the way to the starting stalls and wouldn't budge for anyone. You can't make a horse do something it doesn't want to do. I bet it didn't get much dinner that night, Bon laughed and then added as a joke, I could always do the performance on Tricky. If we painted his legs black and put a big saddle cloth on him to cover his white bits, most people wouldn't know the difference. I'm going to stop there even though it's in the middle of a chapter. There's Naughty Jet looking like a snake and there's Bella being excited at the thought of using Tricky. Okay, I finished that, wouldn't know the difference, so I'll keep going tomorrow. Thanks for listening.